Thanks. Just one other question. I was wondering if doctors start leaving, how worried would you be that it would just snowball and everyone else would just get the hell out?
That's the exact issue we're talking about. In fact, that highlights and is a perfect thing to end on. Doctors are already leaving. So the reason that it's even more of a crisis now is that examples are like I've said, if you were in a, and my colleagues have said, if you're in a clinic with five docs and one leaves, well then 20% increase on sharing your rent and lease and cost. You have another one leave and have another one leave. All of a sudden you have two docs in a clinic space that was got the work of five physicians plus the rent and costs and everything. It's a total vicious cycle that just keeps on going more and more and more. And that's exactly what's happening is that many are already silently quitting in the sense of they're slowly closing down their comprehensive practices, making plans to migrate out of comprehensive care because they see no hope. They don't see the funding model and the hope coming. Dr. Hart, did you have a comment? Yeah, please.
My clinic's been open for 7 years, so I've had five young doctors working with me, of which only one is still doing comprehensive family medicine. The rest has all moved into niche practices. So the new grads in this, a lot of them at this 5 year mark, that whole group under 5 years, none of them are doing it. I work with them at urgent care. They're lovely, competent, smart, fantastic women. Some of them are burnt to a crisp with the expectations of patients. We have to do everything for everybody. They can't sustain raising new families and having babies. I don't know how we did it 20 years ago. We were probably crazy. But they don't do it anymore. They can't do it. So the human beings that are in our workforce, we need to change to get the young people to come and help us because we can't sustain it. They look at us working the hours we're working and they roll their eyes and they run the other way and they can't believe, why are you not wearing nice shoes? Because we have to run. That's why we're wearing ugly shoes. Our world is changing and that funding is not keeping up with it. And we need to, many reasons we have to change stuff.
And that's a perfect note to close on because I think that also highlights exactly when the minister quotes new physician numbers, I'm certain they're correct. It's just they are not doing comprehensive family medicine. That's a perfect thing to just close on. So I appreciate everybody's time and I really appreciate the four my four colleagues here who have it takes courage and we need more voices like this. So I just want to say thanks to the press and thanks to everyone for coming.